Hello, you're watching Proactive London. I'm joined by Robin Brundle, the chairman of Technology Minerals. Robin, very good to see you again.
Yes, good morning. Nice to be with you.
So, Robin, you've announced a deal between Recyclus Group and Service Sure Autocentres. Tell us more about the arrangement.
Yes, well, for us, it's a real milestone because we've been telling our listeners and viewers and shareholders for some time that this is a particular circle that we've specifically gone to close, in that we've offering safe storage, safe logistics, national collection of EV batteries, and obviously with our plant at Wolverhampton, the safe end of life of those batteries as well, so that we can evidence that they really have been end of life rather than stored in buildings or farmyards and so on, as many reports are indicating. So a real milestone for us to have 600 odd or more garages effectively that are doing repairs using our services in this way.
And this falls under Recyclus' arrangement with Slicker Recycling, is that right?
Yes, so Slicker have got a very rich history in collecting hazardous waste materials from the automotive sector, particularly garage lubricants and disposable rags and filters and so on. And so by working with Slicker, it's given us this access to over 100 vehicles through 9 depots across the UK. And they're currently doing around 25,000 collections from the automotive space every year. So by working with them, it's given us that national collection system, and it offers a service to independent or even franchise dealer networks to be able to collect their materials in a timely and safe fashion. So it's a great relationship we have with Slicker. And as I say, a company with a long history in this space, so a great partner to have.
Before we get to the whole transportation of those batteries to your recycling facility in Wolverhampton, Robin, perhaps tell us about the dangers of storing these batteries in boxes and cardboard containers and things.
Yeah, very much so. Well, the automotive space has what seems forever, transported their spare parts either to production lines for the just-in-time concept or through to their dealers in cardboard boxes, on wooden pallets, and even into collapsible plastic, reusable plastic boxes. And so, of course, that needs to change, and we've been beating that drum for a while. And that's why we designed our own LiBox as well, because we knew that there was a gap in safe transportation. And just back to your point, you only have to look about 3 weeks ago where, unfortunately, I think it was an Inchcape Audi dealership in Swindon, sadly, were storing some EV batteries that had a problem and has virtually destroyed the dealership there. And we've also seen over the weekend, a rather large fire in France. And we've heard reports again of ships that have been carrying EV cars across the waters where they've left the dockside in perfect condition. And one has kicked off on the water. And ships are having to float around for 3 or 4 days to allow the fire to abate effectively. So we do know the dangers, and clearly on our sites, we have to make sure that we have full fire abatement systems, and they're tested clearly. We occasionally have small fires that we can see coming because we have thermal imagery, we have smoke detection. And so we're used to dealing with a thermal runaway problem. But of course, if they're out in the community, that knowledge just isn't there. So this is why we're starting to see the increased numbers of fires from batteries that have run into problems.
And do we have dealerships and facilities that are just storing old lithium-ion batteries?
Yeah, I'm sure. So there are virtually all dealerships where they do repairs on the EV batteries. And we're even told through Sureservice that their dealers actually have been storing their batteries for more than 6 years now, because they're, until we came along, you know, there has been nowhere for them to send them safely to be end of life, effectively, until we arrived. So so we are a solution provider for them. And you know, they've been very open that they've got this stock that has been sitting at dealerships for more than 6 years. And it's very good of them to be that open.
Robin, take us through the process. So the batteries are collected, they're put into the live boxes, transported to your recycling facility in Wolverhampton. What happens there?
So the batteries then, once they've been safely transported to us, they arrive on site and they're 100% of the batteries are inspected. So we check them through, clearly logged in. They then go straight through to our processing plant, where we've got the first UK industrial scale plant. And by that, to give you some idea of scale, we have a license permit to process up to 22,000 tons of lithium-ion batteries a year. It's described still as world-leading, because we're able to take all five chemistries of batteries. So what that means is that we can have going up our conveyor belt an e-bike beside a battery, beside a mobile phone, beside a car, beside a train or a forklift truck, and we can process them regardless of chemistry into our plant and safely process them. And we have zero use of water, zero to landfill, and you know, we separate the whole battery in a safe environment and then use all of the materials that come out of the back end.
So, I mean, really illustrating the sustainable circular economy there, Robin.
Yeah, very much so. And, you know, as we've said before, we've got one more piece of the jigsaw that we're looking at, which is to be able to separate something that's called black mass. And the black mass is like a black talcum powder, if you like. And it contains the nickel, the lithium, the cobalt and the manganese. The UK doesn't have that capability to separate right now. So we as a company, being encouraged by government, are looking into ways to separate that so that we can truly keep all of those raw materials here in the UK for use by UK industry effectively.
Robin, will you be looking for other deals similar to the Sureservice Autocentres deal?
We have a number of other deals already in the pipeline. Some of them are with rather large brands as well that you know, clearly are sensitive around brand protection. But yes, we've got a lot of other dominoes now that will hopefully come through and we'll come and talk to you about as they land. Yeah, we're really pleased. We knew we were coming into Q1 with a lot of opportunity about to land. This is the first, and we're working hard on all of those other opportunities, as you can imagine.
Well, Robin, I hope you'll keep us posted on your progress. Thank you very much for speaking with us today.
We will, and nice to talk. Thank you.
That's Robin Brundle, Chairman of Technology Minerals.